Hey there, welcome to a new 5 Medical Chinese video. All up and high we go. Before we start, if you like the videos, tell your friends and colleagues about them. And in this episode, let's look at some important structures of the frontal parietal occipital region. The epicranial aponeurosis, 头盖尖膜, subaponeurotic areolar tissue, 尖膜下, 疏松结缔组织, pericranium, 颅骨膜, the scalp, 头皮, frontal parietal occipital region, 前额顶针部. The epicranial aponeurosis, 头盖尖膜. The epicranial aponeurosis, 头盖尖膜. This is a tough layer of dense fibrous tissue which covers the upper part of the cranium. Subaponeurotic areolar tissue, 尖膜下. 疏松结缔组织. Subaponeurotic areolar tissue, 尖膜下. 疏松结缔组织. It is the loose connective tissue which is located between scalp and pericranium. It's also termed subaponeurotic space. This area is commonly termed the danger area of the skull due to the venous vasculature which allows infection to spread like wildfire to different areas of the brain. Pericranium, 颅骨膜. Pericranium, 颅骨膜. It is thin and dense, and it closely adheres to the cranial sutures and continues to the outer layer of dura mater. The scalp, 头皮. The scalp, 头皮. The scalp is usually described as having 5 layers, which can conveniently be remembered as the mnemonic below. Fifth up is frontal parietal occipital region, 前额顶针部. Frontal parietal occipital region, 前额. This area is arranged in layer. Outermost to innermost is skin, superficial fascia, galea aponeurotica, subaponeurotic areolar tissue, and pericranium. So there we are, my friends, and again, all up and high we go. Repeat and internalize the words. Share and subscribe for more videos. See you next time. Created using Powtoon.